welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is David Elsley, the President and CEO of Cardiol. And David, it's good to have you back. How are you?
I'm doing great, thank you. Good afternoon. It's a pleasure to be here.
Yeah, lots of stuff to talk about. First off, you've just initiated your phase one clinical study of CardiolRx, and this is a Health Canada approved one. So maybe you can tell me a little bit about CardiolRx and this phase one study.
Absolutely. I think this is a very busy time for Cardiol. This study we've just initiated yesterday is very important. This will be a rapidly enrolled trial. We'll enroll about 55 patients over the next 60 days. But the importance of this study is it is the precursor study to entering an international study in acute myocarditis, which for those that aren't aware of what myocarditis is, it's a very important form of heart failure. It's a devastating form of heart failure because it's the leading cause of sudden cardiac death in people under the age of 30. So this is a form of heart failure that takes the lives of young people. And whilst we're all living in this COVID-19 pandemic and becoming aware of this, it's important to understand that the primary cause of acute myocarditis is a viral infection, and COVID-19 is now increasing the number of cases of this devastating disease.
David, why did Cardiol decide to focus so heavily on this rare disease then?
Well, COVID-19 or myocarditis is thankfully a rare disease, but it affects even pre-COVID over 70,000 patients each and every year in the United States. And it's a very important problem. Like if we think about, we're developing prescription cannabinoids, basically, very important. We're developing the anti-inflammatory properties of one of the non-psychoactive cannabinoids, which is pharmaceutical cannabidiol. And if you think about the FDA approval of the first cannabidiol treatment, that was in a patient population of pediatric epilepsy patients, which is about 37,000 patients. But that has now underpinned the development of a multi-billion dollar franchise in the United States. So this is not, it is a rare disease, but it's not unimportant because myocarditis can require intensive care hospitalization. It can lead to heart transplantation. And in very devastating forms of it, it can lead to death.
And we've obviously heard over the last little while, a lot of the health experts and scientists coming out talking about the effects that COVID-19 could have on the younger population. So while, as you say, it's a rare disease right now, we could see a lot more because there's so many things we just don't know about COVID-19 yet.
Absolutely. But one of the things we are increasingly becoming aware of is that COVID-19 is much more than a respiratory distress syndrome. It's affecting multiple organ systems in the body. And one of the most primary organs it's targeting is the heart and the cardiovascular system. So it is really now becoming increasingly recognized as an inflammatory cardiovascular condition. And that's the primary focus of Cardiol. We are developing the anti-inflammatory strategies. We're developing anti-inflammatory strategies and cardioprotective strategies for this very important area of medicine. And the most vulnerable patients to COVID-19 are those with a prior history of cardiovascular disease.
David, a couple more questions for you. I want to talk a little bit about your deal with Shoppers Drug Mart. Give me some ideas to where that is at, and are you hoping to have some commercial products available there soon?
Absolutely. We've spent many years developing the purest form of pharmaceutical cannabidiol in the world. One of the most important contributions that medicine has made to the world to date is in the treatment of pediatric epilepsy. It's helping thousands of children in the United States. But one of the challenges of that FDA-approved medicine is it's extremely expensive at $32,000 a year. So we've created a supply chain that can make that medicine more affordable. And we're very pleased to be on the cusp of introducing this nationally through the most respected distributor of medicines, which is Shoppers Drug Mart. We've had a few supply chain issues over the past few months associated with COVID-19, as many companies around the world have, but we're thankful that we've worked all those out, and we're looking forward to introducing the most advanced form of this important medicine over the next few weeks.
you know, there is a large Canadian medicinal CBD market. Do you feel that Cardiol is positioned in the right spot right now to really take advantage of that market?
Absolutely. I think we're positioned to dominate the most important aspects of that market, which are people that should not be exposed to THC. We've spent the past several years developing the purest form of this important medicine. And one of the key impurities that we have removed from the medicine is THC, because THC can affect brain development in people under the age of 25, and it can be more intoxicating in people over the age of 65. And those two segments, both pediatric applications in conditions such as epilepsy and autism, and then elderly patients who are using it for pain management, those are the patient populations that are the fastest growing and most in need, and they should never be exposed to THC. We'll have the only formulation in Canada that it has the highest level of assurance for patients, doctors, physicians, pharmacists, that it does not have THC.
It was interesting. I was talking to someone, I guess about 6 months ago, and we were talking about the CBD medicinal market specifically. And I asked them, you know, what's one of the biggest challenges that they're seeing? And he said it's convincing doctors and practitioners to sort of say, hey, this is something we should start taking a real serious look at. I know that you've done a lot of work with doctors as well. Can you sort of give me some thoughts on that specifically about practitioners and doctors and getting them to say, look, there is an alternative out there that you really need to look at, and the science and the data is starting to support that?
Sure. What physicians and medical specialists want is they want to be able to understand the medicine that they're prescribing. So if you have a formulation that is has multiple different constituents in it that isn't well characterized or understood, that's very difficult for a physician to support. So we've developed, much like GW Pharma has in the States, we've developed a pure form of cannabidiol. So the only medicinal ingredient in our product is cannabidiol. That's been clearly shown to have a beneficial impact on thousands of children with severe epilepsy seizure syndromes. And we're very pleased that we're about to introduce this to the pediatric neurology market here in Canada and make available a medicine they understand and a medicine that they know works in these seizure syndromes.
Last question, David, and that is, I know that you recently did a capital raise. Maybe you talk a bit about that and how that sort of helps you in trying to hit some milestones in the rest of 2020 and 2021. And can you share some of those with us, the big milestones that you want to hit?
Sure. We're very pleased to have completed a very successful financing. This financing was heavily supported by insiders and founders of the company. Together, myself and employees of this organization, we're over $5 million of that financing. So we are inextricably aligned with building this company, because we're investing in this company. The major milestones we look forward to in the coming months is we plan to initiate a very important program in myocarditis, which is the leading cause of sudden cardiac death in young people, and it is now being induced by COVID-19. We're looking forward to introducing the most advanced form of pharmaceutical cannabidiol in the world through the most respected distribution network, which is Shoppers Drug Mart, to introduce our product nationally. And we're also advancing an entirely new formulation of this important cannabidiol medicine, a new way to introduce it to the body, which is a subcutaneous formulation that we're targeting at the mass market of heart failure, which remains the leading cause of death and disability in the Western world today.
Absolutely. Well, it sounds like it's going to be extremely busy. David, thanks so much for the time. Sure, appreciate it. And then hopefully we'll talk again real soon.
It's great. Thanks for having me.
All right. David Elsley, the president and CEO of Cardiol.